Hello, my dear students. I once again welcome you all for the third revision class on the topic Indian Constitution of the subject PEIC. In the today's discussion, I will cover the structure of Union Executive and the structure of the state legislature. So first of all, let us discuss what is meant by structure of Union Executive. So the Union Executive or the Parliament consists of the President, Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha. Article 79 deals with Union Parliament as shown in the chart. The President is the head of the Union Parliament. The hierarchy for Lok Sabha is as follows: Speaker, Deputy Speaker, Prime Minister, Council of Ministers and Members of Parliament. And the hierarchy for Rajya Sabha is like this: Chairperson, Deputy Chairperson, Prime Minister, Council of Ministers and Members of Parliament. Let us discuss some points with respect to Lok Sabha. Lok Sabha is also called as the lower house or the house of the people. The maximum strength of Lok Sabha is 552 members, out of which 530 members from states, 20 members from union territories and 2 members from Anglo-Indian community who are nominated by the President of India. The Lok Sabha is presided by the Speaker and the members of the Lok Sabha are elected for 5 years. So let us discuss some points on Rajya Sabha. Rajya Sabha is also called as upper house or the Council of States or the Permanent House. The maximum strength of the Rajya Sabha is 250 seats, out of which 238 seats are selected by the state and union territories, and 12 members are nominated by the President of India. The Rajya Sabha is presided by the Chairman, who is nothing but the Vice President of India, and the members of Rajya Sabha are selected for 6 years. Next heading, qualifications to become the Lok Sabha member. First one, he should be a citizen of India. He should not be less than 25 years of age. He should not hold any office of profit under the union government or state government. And he should not be an undischarged insolvent or should not be one declared by a competent court. Next heading, the functions of the Speaker or the presiding officer in Lok Sabha. The Speaker presides over the meetings of Lok Sabha. The Speaker conducts the joint sitting of both the houses of the Parliament. The Speaker certifies the bills passed by the Parliament. The Speaker decides as to who shall speak first. The Speaker maintains the order and discipline in the House. The Speaker qualifies and disqualifies the members in case of misbehavior of the members. The Speaker's signature is necessary for the bills passed in the House. And one of the significant factors for the Speaker is that the Speaker can also vote only when there is a tie in the voting. Next heading, the functions and powers of the Parliament. Let us see first the functions of the Parliament: legislative functions, executive functions, financial functions. And coming to the powers of the Parliament: legislative power, administrative power and financial power. Next heading, the procedure followed in Parliament in making the law. There are three readings. In the first reading, an ordinary bill may be introduced in any house. This can be proposed by any member of Parliament. First, 1 month's notice is given to the Speaker before the introduction of bill. Then, on the date fixed by the Speaker, the proposer stands up to move the drafted bill and reads it. This is first reading. The next stage is second reading. It takes place after the period of 2 days after the first reading. The bill is read by the proposer, and the bill may be taken for consideration by the House at once, or it may be sent to select committee of the House, or it may be sent to Joint Select Committee of the two houses, or it may be circulated for getting public opinion. If the bill is sent to Select Committee, the committee makes a careful study of the bill and reports back to the House with some corrections. Now, the bill is debated clause by clause. This stage gives final shape to the bill. Now, it is sent for voting. Once it is passed by majority votes, it is submitted for third reading. The third stage is third reading. The third reading is a formal reading and no debate takes place here. Now, it is transferred to the next house where it goes through all above three stages. If the other house accepts the bill, it is sent to the president for the assent. After the president's approval, a bill becomes act or law. Next heading, functions and powers of the president. Under the Article 53, the president has the following powers. The first one is executive powers. The president appoints prime minister and ministers of the union cabinet as per prime minister's recommendations. The president appoints judges of Supreme Court and High Courts, Attorney General of India, election commissioners, governors, ambassadors, members of UPSC, etc. And the president carries out all executive actions and he controls union territories. The second power of the president is legislative power. He assents the bills passed by the two houses of the parliament. He addresses the members of two houses together and he nominates 12 members to Rajya Sabha and two Anglo-Indian members to Lok Sabha. The third power of the president is judicial power. He can appoint or remove the judges of Supreme Court and High Court. He has the power to grant pardons, remission of punishments, etc. He can take action against any citizen of India who has committed contempt of the house. The fourth power of the president is financial power. The president approves the budget. He can grant financial aid to different states. He can collect money in the form of income tax, customs, etc. Coming to the emergency powers of the president, he may impose the president rule in the state. He can declare financial emergency and he can declare the war. Next, power, diplomatic power. The president may send or receive the ambassadors and other diplomatic representatives, and he can sign the international treaties and agreements. Next heading, the powers and functions of the Prime Minister. The Prime Minister has the power of selecting, changing and removing the ministers from his government. He communicates to President for all decisions for the Council of Ministers. He fixes the dates for parliamentary sessions and its programs. He acts as a leader of ruling party of Parliament. He takes all members into confidence. He is the chairman of the Planning Commission and makes the economic plans. He represents all national and international conferences and summits. He is the chief spokesman of government in foreign affairs, the diplomats, delegates, high commissioners, etc. And the Prime Minister recommends the dissolution of his government to the president. Now, let us discuss about the important headings on the structure of the state legislation. The state legislature consists of governor, legislative assembly and legislative council. The structure of the state legislature is like this. The governor is the constitutional head of the state legislature. The hierarchy for Legislative Assembly or Vidhan Sabha is like this. Speaker, Deputy Speaker, Chief Minister, Council of Ministers and members of Legislative Assembly. The hierarchy for Legislative Council or Vidhan Parishad is as follows. Chairperson, Chief Minister, Council of Ministers and members of Legislative Council. Let us first discuss the Legislative Assembly or Vidhan Sabha. Vidhan Sabha is a popular house consisting of members who are directly elected by the people from different constituencies in the state. It consists of not more than 500 and less than 60 members. The strength is fixed on the basis of population in the state. Governor can nominate one member from Anglo-Indian community. Some seats are reserved for SC and ST. The members of the Legislative Assembly are directly elected by the people for a term of 5 years from the date of first meeting. These members elect the Speaker and the Deputy Speaker. Now, let us go to the discussion of Legislative Council or Vidhan Parishad. Vidhan Parishad is the upper house of the state legislature and it is not present in all the states. Only we can find it in Bihar, Karnataka, UP, Maharashtra and Jammu and Kashmir. The strength of the Vidhan Parishad should not be less than 40 members and should not exceed the 2/3 of the total members in Legislative Assembly of the state. It consists of both elected and nominated members of 5 different categories. The first category is 1/3 members are elected by members of Legislative Assembly from amongst who are not the members of Legislative Assembly. 1/3 members are elected by members of local self-governing bodies like municipalities, panchayats, etc. 1/12 members are elected by teachers of secondary schools and colleges. 1/12 of members are elected by registered graduates. 1/6 of members are nominated by the governor of the state from persons who have involved in science, art, cooperative movement and social service, etc. The members of Legislative Council are elected for 6 years. Next heading, the powers and functions of the governor. He exercises all executive powers to all executive actions of the state. He appoints the leader of majority party as a chief minister in the Legislative Assembly. He appoints all other ministers of the council according to the advice of the chief minister. He gives oath of office to the chief minister and to all other ministers. He looks after the smooth running of the government. He dissolves the Legislative Assembly on the advice of chief minister. He addresses the member of the state assembly. He gives assent to the bills passed by the government and may reject it for reconsideration. He appoints the judge of high court in consult with president and he appoints new chief minister in hung assembly. Now the next heading, the last heading, the powers and functions of the chief minister. So the first function of the chief minister towards the governor are like this. He is the mediator link between the governor and the council of ministers. He informs about decision taken in the council of ministers to the governor. He gets the permission of governor whenever necessary. He advises or recommends governor to appoint a person as a minister and allocates portfolios. And he recommends the governor to dissolve the state assembly after the completion of 5 years. Secondly, towards the council of ministers, the three functions are, he is the president of the council of ministers. He is present in all cabinet meetings and he monitors the working of all ministers and oversees the meetings. The last one is towards the state legislature. Under this, three functions are there. All the policies are announced by him on the floor of house. He has to get the bills passed in the house and he is the chairman of state planning commission. So these are the discussions of the today's revision class. So I thank all the students for attending this class. And in the third part, so we shall see the remaining headings on the Constitution of India. Thank you once again to all.